republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Clerk, please call the roll.
Leo. Backholden. Brandon Horst.
Here.
Dan Stryland.
Here.
Skibo.
Here.
Peterson.
Here.
I would like to announce that there will be a policy and planning meeting following the regular council meeting to discuss the community center gymnasium ceiling. On to item number two, approval of the tentative agenda. Do I hear a motion for approval?
Second.
Skibo, support Peterson. Any discussion? I don't have to look over to this side tonight, do I? All the action is happening over here.
All the light.
Seeing no discussion, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Skibo.
Yes.
Peterson.
Yes.
Brandon Horst.
Yes.
Dan Stryland.
Yes.
Motion carried. On to item three, reappointment of Brent Lancer to the Building Code Board of Appeals. Brent Lancer is interested in serving another term on the Building Code Board of Appeals. Brent has served on the board since August 1st, 2007, and has attended all five meetings held since that term began. He is a business owner operating Lancer Home Service and carries plumbing and mechanical contractors' licenses. Brent and his family reside at 1258 Iowa Street. His position is one of two that are the residents within the 2-mile extraterritorial jurisdiction in Marion County. If approved, Brent's new term would expire on August 1st, 2023. Your motion for approval. Skibo.
Support.
Support Ben Stryland. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Skibo.
Yes.
Dan Stryland.
Yes.
Peterson.
Yes.
Brandon Horst.
Yes.
Motion carried. On to item number four, reappointment of Jody Lautenbach to the Community Development Committee. Jody Lautenbach is interested in serving another term on the Community Development Committee. Jody has served on the committee since August 21st, 2012, and has attended 18 of the last 23 meetings. Her position is one of two that are residents of the 2-mile extraterritorial jurisdiction in Marion County. Jody is a broker associate realtor with Pella Realty Group and does property management. Jody resides with her husband at 1021 218th Avenue. If approved, Jody's new term would expire August 1st, 2021. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Brandon Horst.
Support.
Support Peterson. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Brandon Horst.
Yes.
Peterson.
Yes.
Dan Stryland.
Yes.
Skibo.
Yes.
Motion carried. On to number five, reappointment of Wayne Steenstra to the Community Development Committee. Wayne Steenstra is interested in serving another term on the Community Development Committee. Wayne has served on the committee since January 7th, 2003 and has attended 19 of the last 23 meetings. He is an active historic preservationist and resides at 1019 Park Lane. If approved, Wayne's new term would expire on August 1st, 2021. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved. Support.
Peterson and support Ben Stryland. Discussion? All in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Peterson.
Yes.
Ben Stryland.
Yes.
Skibo.
Yes.
Brandon Horst.
Yes.
Motion carried. Item six, appointment of Lowell Oliver Shaw to the Community Development Committee. I would like to appoint Lowell Oliver Shaw to serve on the Community Development Committee. Mr. Oliver Shaw is a Pella native, having graduated from Pella Christian High School. He is currently employed as the conference coordinator for Central College, a position he has held for the past 18 years. Mr. Oliver Shaw has a passion for all things Dutch, including design, and has traveled to the Netherlands nearly 10 times over the past several years. Mr. Oliver Shaw is active in the community, serving on the Pella Convention and Visitors Board, as well as participating in several other community activities. If approved, Mr. Oliver Shaw's new term would expire on August 1st, 2021. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Brandon Horst?
Support.
Support Ben Stryland. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Brandon Horst?
Yes.
Dan Stryland?
Yes.
Skibo?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Motion carried. On to number seven, appointment of Lila Turnbull to the Pella Historic Preservation Commission. I would like to appoint Lila Turnbull to serve on the Historic Preservation Commission. This will be Ms. Turnbull's first term serving on the commission. Ms. Turnbull has attended several conferences and training sessions regarding historic preservation and restored the property prominent Victorian home located at 1261 185th Street. She is currently retired and has experience as an interior designer. Ms. Turnbull resides at 401 Union Street. If approved, Ms. Turnbull's new term would expire on January 1st, 2021. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Ms. Kiebel?
Support.
Support Brandenhorst. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Ms. Kiebel?
Yes.
Brandenhorst?
Yes.
Van Strylen?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Motion carried. Now's the time for the public forum. If there's anyone in attendance that would like to address the council regarding any agenda items, please step forward, use the microphone, and give us your name, where you live. Please limit your comments to 3 minutes. Seeing none, we'll move on to the approval of the consent agenda. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Ms. Kiebel?
Support.
Support Peterson? Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Ms. Kiebel?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Brandenhorst?
Yes.
Van Strylen?
Yes.
Motion carried. On to petitions and communications. Number 1A, a special event permit request for Central College Move In, Move Out. Mike, please explain.
Yes, Mr. Mayor, I'd like to refer everyone's attention to the big board for a brief presentation on this item. And this special event permit request is from Central College. As the mayor stated, the purpose of this special event permit is to accommodate students that may be moving in or moving out of Central College during the upcoming academic school year. Listed on the big board are the dates that are being proposed to close Broadway Street between Peace and University Streets that we have up here. It's important to note that this is an annual request from Central College, and it's very similar to what's been approved in previous years as well. It's important to note, Mr. Mayor, that all 30 departments have reviewed the application this evening. The fee and insurance certificate have also been received, and city staff is recommending approval.
Very good. Thank you, Mike. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Support.
Ben Strylen and Skibout. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Van Strylen?
Yes.
Skibout?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Brandenhorst?
Yes.
Motion carried. On to 1B, resolution number 5882, entitled Resolution Temporarily Closing Public Ways or Grounds in Connection with a Special Event, known as Central College Move In, Move Out. Mike, was there anything to add?
No, sir.
Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Skibout?
Support.
Support Peterson. Discussion? All in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Skibout? Peterson?
Yes.
Brandenhorst?
Yes.
Van Strylen?
Yes.
On to resolutions. Number one, resolution number 5883, entitled Resolution Declaring the Agreement for Private Development by and between the City of Pella and Agile Manufacturing Limited terminated in its entirety and approving and authorizing execution of the termination agreement and the IEDA contract termination agreement. Mike, if you'd explain, please.
Yes, Mr. Mayor, I'd be happy to. Once again, I'd like to refer everyone's attention to the big board for a very brief presentation on this item. In background on this, council is aware in March of 2017, we did approve a development agreement for Agile Manufacturing, and the purpose of this was to provide financial incentives to open and operate the services business. Our development agreement was intended to complement the state of Iowa's development agreement they had with Agile Manufacturing as well, and specifically our agreement was intended to meet the part of open managed by the Iowa Economic Development Authority, which is roughly 20% of the total financial award to Agile Manufacturing. Let's go ahead, please, Court. Now, this request that we are entertaining this evening has come from Agile Manufacturing, and the reason they are requesting to terminate the agreement is that they've indicated that they will be focusing more on retail sales of 3D printing equipment, and they will not be able to meet the job creation requirements stated under the agreement. The state of Iowa has already terminated their agreement because the financial incentives that they had in place were directly related to the job creation requirements. They're asking for a similar termination from the city of Pella this evening. Now, as far as our agreement that is being asked to terminate is we had a $9,000 forgivable loan and also a 60-month no interest loan of $9,000 as well. We have not advanced any funds to Agile Manufacturing this evening, Mr. Mayor. So in essence, since Agile Manufacturing has been the party that is requesting to terminate the agreement has already been terminated by the state of Iowa, we are recommending approval for resolution this evening to terminate our development agreement. And with that, Mr. Mayor, we'd be more than happy to answer any questions that your council may have on this item.
Thank you, Mike. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Ben Strylen and support Skiba. Discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Dan Straylin.
Yes.
Skibout. Peterson.
Yes.
Rainer Horst.
Yes.
Motion carried. On to number two, resolution number 5884, entitled Resolution Approving Ordering the Preparation of Plans and Specifications, Form of Contract, Notice of Hearing, and Notice of Letting, Setting the Date for Public Hearing, Authorizing the Taking of Bids, and Authorizing Bid Opening for the Vermeer Trail Construction Project. Mike, can you explain, please?
I guess, Mr. Mayor, we should try. In essence, what we're asking is council to do, like we talked about the Vermeer Trail Project, reality is, all we're asking is what this resolution does. It simply establishes September 4th as the public hearing date for the proposed project. And it gives staff all authorization to take on any available action to conduct the bid letting for the project and actually present a proposed contract for council's consideration on September 4th. Now, the proposed project that we have is, what's being proposed is connect Vermeer Corporation to the city's trail system that we have here. What the project will do is install a 10-foot bike trail on the north side of University Street that would connect Madison Elementary School right over here, would extend easterly to 240th Avenue. At that time, we would cross 240th Avenue and on the east side of 240th Avenue all the way to Vermeer Corporation with a 10-foot bike trail. With that. So let's go ahead and explore it. Now, as far as the engineer on the project is, Arden and Associates, they have given us the probable cost. PowerPoint has an expressed number up here. The actual estimate is $469,000 for that, for the project as far as the construction contract is concerned. Now, if council were to approve this resolution, the critical dates are identified on the big board. What we would be doing is we hold a bid letting for the project on August 23rd of this month. Council would actually consider a proposed contract on September 4th, and if everything proceeded to that point was approved by the city council, we would actually begin the authorization to the contract to begin the project on September 14th or mid-September of this year. With all, if everything holds with weather, heavily scheduled work calls for completion by June of next year. So with this, Mr. Mayor, all we're simply asking is the council set September 4th as the public hearing date for the proposed Vermeer Trail project.
Good. Thank you, Mike. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Peterson?
Support.
Support for Rainer Horst. Any discussion?
The only thing does that, is that engineering, is there something specific under the engineering? Costs seem a little bit high.
Well, that's a piece we've already approved too, but yeah, over half of that, over 50% of that is staking and construction inspection.
Okay.
So you split it up into two, it doesn't look quite as bad.
Is that blacktop or PCC?
It's PCC.
Okay.
Yeah, good. 5 and 6 inch. And this is with the cable guardrail, just like across
just like down
street.
by the lake.
Yep.
Very good. Any other questions? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Peterson?
Yes.
Rainer Horst?
Yes.
Dan Straylin?
Yes.
Skibout?
Yes.
Motion carried. On to number three, resolution number 5885, entitled a resolution accepting the public improvements for the Caldwell Park Improvement Project. Mike, please explain, please.
Yes, Mr. Mayor, I'd be happy to. What this resolution simply does is it accepts the public improvements for the Caldwell Park Improvement Project. Now, as council is aware, we did enter a contract for your construction in August of 2017. We have a brief description of the work that took place under the contract. In essence, we made significant improvements to the shelter house at Caldwell Park. There's also a new skate park in the area. We've also installed with 6 new pickleball courts. And we've also made an addition of installing a portable ice skating rink in the middle of the public park shelter house for this as well. So let's go ahead, please, for it. Now, as far as the summary of cost for the project, we started off with an original contract of $769,000. Council did approve the change of various change orders for the project to just shy of $5,000. So we have a revised construction contract amount of just shy of $774,000. The engineer for the project was Billiard and Associates, and they are recommending acceptance of the project as they do believe the project was completed in accordance with the plans and specifications this evening, Mr. Mayor. So with that, Mr. Mayor, what we're simply doing is accepting the project and also authorizing payment or change for the project as well. The reason for this, our engineer is recommending or stated that they believe the project was completed in accordance with the plans and specifications approved by the Pella City Council.
All right, very good. Thank you, Mike. Do I hear a motion for approval?
Support.
Support Dan Straylin. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Skibout.
Yes.
Dan Straylin.
Yes.
Peterson.
Yes.
Rainer Horst.
six, entitled Resolution Approving Change Order Number Two, Final Quantity Adjustment, Authorizing Final Payment, Acceptance of Contract Construction, and Acceptance of Final Completion of the Project Known as the West Substation 69 KV Ring Bus Project. Mike, if you can explain.
Yes, Mr. Mayor, I'd be happy to. As the mayor stated, what this resolution will do is approve change order number two. We'll explain that just a bit. Final quantities adjustment for the West Substation Reconfiguration Project, commonly known as the Ring Bus Project. As council is aware, in May of 2016, we entered into a contract for the project, and really what we did was converted us from a single breaker scheme at the West Substation to a ring bus scheme. What that in essence did was gave both our circuit breaker protection for the various transformers and connections at the 69 kV or 69,000 volt transmission line connections to the substation would be protected by circuit breakers instead of connecting to a middle circuit breaker or power line with the substation. The project was all in the name of reliability. It's very important. It's a very important reliability asset for the community as well. So let's go ahead, please, Corey. Now, change order number two that we are considering tonight actually decreases the amount of the contract and its quantities adjustment. So what we're simply doing is reconciling what the contract originally did for the materials for the project and what was actually placed on the project and incorporated into the job. Change order that we're considering tonight would actually be construction of a contract reduction, of $3,351 in pipes and council would result in a revised contract of $1,860,068. Now, the engineer for the project is DGR, and they are recommending the acceptance of the project, and they also believe the project was completed in accordance with approved plans and specifications. So with that, Corey, is that
that's
the slides that we have there?
That's it.
Okay. And so with that, Mr. Mayor, we might be happy to answer any questions the mayor and council may have on this item.
Thank you, Mike. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Matt Stryland?
Support.
Support Peterson. Discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Stryland?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Brandenhorst?
Yes.
Skiba?
Yes.
Motion carried. On to number five, resolution number 5887, entitled Resolution Approving Change Order Number One, a Final Quantity Adjustment, and Accepting the Public Improvements for the West Washington Street and IA 163 Eastbound Exit Ramp Intersection Improvement Project. Mike, if you'd explain, please.
Okay, very similar to the previous resolution, just approved by council. What this resolution would do is, again, would have been identify and approve the final quantities adjustment for change order number one for the traffic signals that were installed at the West Washington Street Highway 63 interchange project. Now, as council is aware, last September, the city did enter a contract with TK Concrete for the project. We have a description of the project and what was actually installed on the west end of town for the traffic signals. This is the public report. Corey, let's go ahead, please. Now, change order number one that we are considering tonight is a quantities reduction in the job. Again, this is just a simple reconciliation of the materials that we used for the project compared with the contract we did for the project. We started off with an original contract at $550,994. Change order number one that we are considering tonight is a contract reduction in the amount of $6,912. Council order approved this change order tonight to meet this with the revised contract amount of $544,081.74. But let's go ahead, please, Corey. Now, the engineer for the project was Snyder & Associates, and they have stated that the project was completed with the importance of three plans and specifications by the public that were established by the Pella City Council. It is important to note that this resolution also authorizes the release of the retainage to the contractor in the amount of just over $27,200. Now, very important to note that we have an overall project cost for this. The state of Iowa will be contributing to the project, but unfortunately, before there is any type of reimbursement, we have to complete the project. So upon approval of this resolution tonight, we will be filing a claim reimbursement with the state of Iowa for a $200,000 reimbursement from the state for the installation of the traffic signals. So with that, Mr. Mayor, we'd be more than happy to answer any questions the mayor and council may have on this item.
Thank you, Mike. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Keep out.
Support.
Support Brandenhorst. Discussion? I want to go on record as saying I love that interchange. It is fabulous. I go through it every day. So, seeing no other questions or discussion, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Skiba?
Yes.
Brandenhorst?
Yes.
Yes. Stryland?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Motion carried. Number six, resolution number 5888. entitled a resolution approving an agreement for the professional services with Short Elliott Hendrickson, Inc. for the development of a facilities need assessment. Mike, could you explain, please?
Yes, Mr. Mayor, and once again, with this resolution to approve a professional services agreement, as the mayor said, with Short Elliott Hendrickson, commonly referred to as an acronym SEH. And the purpose of the contract is to develop a facility needs assessment for the city of Pella. Now, it's very important to note, when we talk about the facility needs assessment, what this is going to do is establish a long-term plan to address the city's facility needs through the year 2040. It's roughly a 20-year plan that we're talking about that will be formed to do this contract. We have listed up on the big board the facilities that are included within the contract. It's important to note that we do have some vacant property that will also be assessed as a part of the contract, but this is just the facilities part as well. Let's go ahead, please, Corey. Now, as far as getting to this recommendation, as far as recommending the contract tonight, it's important to note that we did solicit bids for these services. We had six firms, architectural and engineering firms, that did submit proposals to the city of Pella for consideration. We had our department heads rank the proposals with them. From those six, we narrowed it down to two finalists, and we did conduct in-person interviews on them. SEH was scored both the highest on the initial ranking by the department heads, and they were the preferred choice based on the in-person interviews as well. Now, as background on SEH, they were founded in 1927. They have 31 locations that are located throughout the Midwest. I think it's a fair statement that they have significant experience in conducting facility plans for municipalities as well. And with that, that was part of the reason we felt comfortable making this recommendation to SEH, is that the amount of experience and professionalism that they will bring to the job in establishing a plan for the city of Pella. Let's go ahead, please, Corey. Now, what we have up here is an overview of the scope of services that will be conducted by SEH, and I'd like to focus in on the middle section here because this has received a considerable amount of discussion in the community. As a part of this, there will be an evaluation of the Pella Community Center. It's very important to note that the consultant will be updating the 2013 assessment that we had. So what this assessment would be is, what would be the cost if we wanted to renovate the Pella Community Center? Today's dollars, we'll have that update of the assessment. Once that's done, SEH will also compare the cost of the renovation to building new. Once we have that, it's very important to note that they will be making a recommendation to council. Now, one of the key things in making this recommendation to council, as we talked about the community center, is the city of Pella will be identifying the four focus groups for SEH to interview and discuss as far as usage level on the Pella Community Center. So those key stakeholder groups take place. They're also going to update the assessment. They're also going to take a look at the cost of updating the Pella Community Center to building new. And they will be making a recommendation to the Pella City Council on future plans for the community center as well. So with this, the full scope of services, the completion date for the facility plan is December of 2018. That's very important to note. Once again, what we're talking about is a long-term plan for the city's facilities that will take a look at usage levels for each one of the city facilities. It will help us develop a plan for the next 20 years on our facilities. So, Corey, is there any additional slides that we have in here? Of course. What would be a presentation without talking about fees? Shame on me for almost forgetting that. What's being proposed tonight is a proposed fee for the services of $44,000 plus actual trackable expenses, which is a not-to-exceed amount of $2,000. Now, considering the complexity of the analysis, particularly when we take a look at the community center aspect of this, we believe the fees are very reasonable considering the scope of services associated with the project. So it is our recommendation tonight to approve the agreement with SEH to develop a long-term facility needs for the city of Pella. We talk about long-term, and they emphasize this for the next 20 years. We're looking at the date 2040. What will be the city of Pella's facility needs for 2040? Council approves this resolution. We'll have a report to present to you in December of this year, Mr. Mayor. With that, we'd be more than happy to answer any questions this prayer that the council may have on this item.
Thank you, Mike. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Second.
Peterson and support from Stratlin. Any discussion?
Did we get any references?
Yes, we did check references on the planner, our staff did. And what we found out is SEH has significant experience in both facility needs assessments, but in particular in working on community centers on it as well. And so we felt comfortable based on the references on this as well.
What are some of the cities? Just out of curiosity, do you have
Corey on the spot?
Yeah, Corey and Mandy.
Was Lyons, Colorado, I think, was that
basically identical to what we were looking to do when we referenced that one, so.
Okay.
That seems to stick in my mind.
And we also have Mr. Lucas Casey of SEH here tonight as well. Council would have questions with her as well.
Have you done some Iowa communities?
I go there.
Yeah, you just answered from there.
Okay, yes. Lucas Casey with SEH 5414, West 88th Street, Johnson. I know some councils would like to hear all that, so I'm used to rattling it all off. We've been in the Iowa market through acquisitions and mergers for just over 10 years. And some of our Iowa references that we provided were Spirit Lake. We've done a city hall, which of course began with the facilities needs and programming assessment. And then we went on and did the law enforcement center there too. That construction was just completed. We're currently working on a fire and rescue facility in Madrid, Iowa, closer to kind of opposite the metro area from you here. Also in southwestern Iowa in Griswold. But the vast majority of our experience is kind of concentrated in Minnesota where we were founded. And the reference that Corey alluded to was in Avon, Colorado. And it was it was very similar, very good reference. A number of facilities looked at the potential of renovating on site, consolidation of facilities into new facilities, relocation for efficiency, and cost analysis.
Any other questions or discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Peterson?
Yes.
Van Strylen?
Yes.
Skibo?
Yes.
Brandhorst?
Yes.
Motion carried. On to ordinances. Number one, ordinance number 944, entitled ordinance repealing section 120.05 sub 11 of the Pella City Code and adopting a new section 120.05 sub 11 relating to the prohibited sales and acts. This is the second reading. Mike, can you explain, please?
Yes, Mr. Mayor, I'd be happy to provide a summary on this item. We've gone over this numerous times, so I'll move rather quickly through the presentation. If it was too quick, please slow me down. I'd be happy to address any questions the council may have. But in essence, what this proposed ordinance does is amends the city code, and what it does is allows persons under the age of 21 to remain on the premises of a microbrewery until 9 p.m., only if they're accompanied by a parent or the guardian. Currently, it's very important to note that the city code prohibits minors or persons under the age of 21 from being on the premises of an establishment which also holds a liquor license or a beer and wine permit. The exception for this is restaurants. And under the city zoning code, a restaurant is defined where the volume of sales volume is more than 50% is derived or generated from the sale of certain food. In those cases, establishments we use an offense if restaurant minors are allowed to be on site. Let's go ahead, please, Court. Now, it's very important to note when we talk about the terms of the microbrewery within the differentiation between microbreweries and bars and taverns and cocktail lounges as well as restaurants, in particular under the city zoning code, a microbrewery cannot obtain a Class C liquor license. What this means is they're unable to sell spirits or hard alcohol, and that's very important to note when we're talking about having minors on the present on premise with that as well. For microbreweries, they will not be able to sell hard alcohol or spirits. And as we stated earlier, that's one of the key differences between a microbrewery and a bar and a tavern. Very important to note also that in the city of Pella, microbreweries are permitted through a special use permit process, which allows the Board of Adjustment, in essence, to take a look at the proposed location for the microbrewery, and the overall intention of the special use permit process is to help ensure that it's a good fit for the surrounding area. Now, we can have detail on that as well for you. Let's go ahead. But all these aspects are part of the city's special use permit process we have, and what we're looking for is basic health and safety items that we have here. We're also going to take a look and ensure that the microbrewery, that we have adequate infrastructure to serve the proposed microbrewery. But a big portion of the process is land use compatibility. Now, as a part of this, Courtney, let's go ahead, please. There will be a public hearing prior to any issuance of a special use permit for this. Through the process, we'll notify neighboring property owners. Also advertise on legal publication as well for the public hearing. This will provide a forum for any parties that may be located in close proximity to the microbrewery that would have concerns with it. They have a voice to voice that in the city, those concerns are stated, those concerns prior to the Board of Adjustment taking action on it as well. Very important to note as council is aware that this is more for the members that may be in the audience or watching at home. The Board of Adjustment will also have wide-ranging
Pella City zoning code, that's how we've established the microbreweries, because the city additional regulation over microbreweries as well, and that's regulated through the Board of Adjustment with a wide range of authority with it. And just as the Board of Adjustment can issue special use permits in the case of which problems, those special use permits for any type of entity that holds it could also be revoked as well. Let's go ahead, please, Corey. Now, following up on microbreweries and considering this, we did survey a number of cities with that have microbreweries, restaurants, bars, and taverns. And I will state up front, the terminology in the microbrewery business is different compared to some cities. Some cities differentiate and call microbreweries different than bars and taverns. Some cities just call them bars and taverns. Others call them restaurants even as well. So it really depends on the city. So please keep that in mind as we go through our list of comparisons up here on the big board. Let's go ahead, please, Corey. What we have up here are some cities that deal exclusively or have significant experience in the microbrewery business. What you see up there, again, it really depends on the classification, how they treat it under the Pella zoning code. Des Moines, for instance, consider microbreweries. They want them to they classify the same as bar and tavern. It's very important to note that in the city of Des Moines, minors can be on presence in a bar and tavern. They do not regulate that, and there are also no hour restrictions as well. Of all the cities that we have up here, as far as regulations, one of the cities that the microbreweries are more heavily regulated is in the city of West Des Moines. And if you wanted to compare our microbrewery ordinance, West Des Moines also requires a special use permit for microbreweries as well. We also require a parent legal guardian to be on premise at the microbrewery, if the minor is on premise at a microbrewery, there has to be 21 years as well. So if you want to compare our ordinance as well, we're very similar to West Des Moines. We regulated for a special use permit. We also require the parent legal guardian to be in the minor under 21. But in our case, it's a little different from all these other cities up here. What's also included in this proposed ordinance is minors can be home, be on site morning until 9 p.m. under the proposed ordinance as well. So if you were to look at all these cities up here, we compare very favorably or very similar to the city of West Des Moines. Let's go ahead, please, Corey. Now what we have there listed on the board is the terminology of the modification under the city ordinance, and what was being added is everything that's being outlined here. But in essence, what this proposed ordinance would allow would allow minors to locate the on-premise of a microbrewery only if they're accompanied by a parent or legal guardian 21 years or older, and only until 9 p.m. as well. So let's go ahead to this point. Now, in addition, it's very important to note Class C liquor license under the Pella City Code. Microbreweries cannot obtain a Class C liquor license. It would be Class B, which would permit only beer and wine to sell, as well as hard alcohol that would be sold to the microbrewery. Let's go ahead, please, Corey. Now, in reviewing the proposed ordinance, we believe between the Class C liquor license restriction, special use permit requirements for minors, and also the requirement that they're accompanied by a parent or legal guardian, along with the time limitation for the curfew right here, based on the culmination of these factors or requirements under the proposed ordinance that's being proposed this evening as well, it's already under city code, we are recommending approval of the proposed ordinance this evening, Mr. Mayor. And with that, I know that was a rather lengthy presentation and stated what I intended to do this evening, but we'd be more than happy to answer the questions the mayor and council may have on this item.
Thank you, Mike. Do I hear a motion for approval?
So moved.
Peterson?
Support.
Or Branderhorst? Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Peterson?
Yes.
Branderhorst?
Yes.
Dan Stryland?
Yes.
Skiba?
Yes.
Motion carried. On to claims, abstract of bills number 2012. Do I hear a motion for approval?
Move to approve and issue warrants.
Motion to approve and issue warrants by Skiba. Support by Peterson. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk, call the roll.
Skiba?
Yes.
Peterson?
Yes.
Branderhorst?
Yes.
Van Stryland?
Yes.
Motion carried. On to other business. Do any council members have any other business that needs to be brought before the group at this time?
That's kind of a minor issue, but I had a few people complain about the chalkboards downtown, but especially, you know, the chalkboards.
The sandwich boards.
Yeah. And I noticed, you know, in Oscaloosa, when they do have happen. They have them right next to the structures, right next to the buildings, and not in the middle.
That's where they're supposed to be.
And especially with the blind gal, Sherry Bewalda, who scratched herself running into them. It's a little different, I suppose, with a sighted person.
Right.
When a non-sighted person, you know, is already going around the tables and the chairs and...
Sure.
And then they do move around a little bit.
Right.
So anyway, I...
Chief, can we make a note to kind of look for those? And I think we're required to be within 9 inches of the building or something then.
I don't think, Mr. Mayor, our planning and zoning department will handle that, or we'll refer that to our...
Okay.
Jared Parker, code enforcement officer.
You don't want to drag anybody away in cuffs, do you, Chief?
Yeah.
We'll go out and look at it tomorrow morning.
It hasn't been too many people, but with a non-sighted person, it's a little different than...
Yeah, that makes sense. Appreciate it. Anything else that we need to talk about? Seeing none from the group, I'll open it up to the rest of the communities. Anybody have anything that needs to be brought before the council at this time? Young man, do you have anything to say? No? All right. Do I hear a motion to adjourn? Motion to adjourn by Skibout. All in favor, please say yes. Opposed, no. Clerk call roll. Peterson did. I saw him shake his head.
Skibout.
Yes.
Peterson.
Yes.
Brandon Horse.
Yes.
Van Strylen.
Yes.
We are adjourned.